Hi guys, welcome to Beard's Eye View, and this is going to be all the things that I purchased in November. Before we begin, don't forget to like and comment down below, subscribe and ring the bell to be notified whenever I do videos. I do them every single Wednesday, so make sure you keep a lookout for those. Yes, another nerd purchase thing. I know it's been a while. This is probably going to be the last one before Christmas now, really, because obviously I can't afford to be buying myself stuff this close to Christmas, but hopefully I'll do one over Christmas of all the things I got at Christmas time, so obviously keep a lookout for that one. But this is what I've got in November, because I recently just went to Comic-Con in Birmingham. They do it, I think, 2-3 times a year, and November one's always a big one because it's just before Christmas, and it was absolutely packed. There was loads of cosplayers there. It was epic. So many people with so much effort in. There's so many stores, loads of Funkos, loads of different like toys and collectibles and all this kind of stuff. All great stuff, as you know what happens with Comic-Con. Loads of signings. I saw Anthony Daniels, you know, C-3PO. That was cool. But yeah, it was just a fun day out to go and buy some bits and bobs, and I got myself some last bits before the Christmas shopping. First thing I got, this t-shirt. We literally found a stall that was like 2 for £20 with like hoodies and t-shirts and stuff. So the missus got herself a hoodie, and I got myself a t-shirt. And I looked at loads of different ones. I couldn't make my mind up. But in the end, I went for a Thanos Avengers Endgame kind of one. Because I like the colour, the grey colour. I like the gold and the purple. And I actually kind of like the fact that all the Avengers are around him and everything. I just thought it was a cool t-shirt. I thought, for a tenner, you can't go wrong. A couple of the things that I picked up were one of those Disney things that you kind of put onto, I can't remember what they used them for. I really can't remember what they were called either, to be honest. But a store was selling them for like £5 a piece. So I thought, I quite like having these things as like a desktop thing on my computer at work or at home. So I thought, you know, a little thing to kind of add to that. And I got myself Star-Lord and Luke Skywalker. I know these are quite old and they've been out for quite a while, but I've never collected any of them. I just thought, again, like putting them on a desktop and that, just a little fun way to kind of jazz up your display at work or something like that. So there is Star-Lord, which is probably my favourite out of the two. Just the detail's so cool. It just looks really kind of funky. And like, see, there's like a scan thing like underneath. I can't remember what they were for. I really can't. And then there's Luke Skywalker as well, which, again, why not? You know what I mean? Because Skywalker is a cool character. Bought myself a new wallet. I had an R2-D2 one. Absolutely loved that wallet. I had it for, I think, probably about almost 3 years now or something. But it just, over time, it just faded away, as wallets tend to do. So I bought myself a new one, and I was going to go kind of all out again with a really geeky one. And this is to a point, but it's a little bit slicker and not as out there. And it's a Legend of Zelda wallet. And I actually think this is pretty slick. If you look a bit closely, it's just the brown, gold and green. Just really nice leather look. It's just obviously got that on the back. And it's, you know, it's really good. It's got all the stuff kind of inside it and whatnot. Driver's license. So you've got the Zelda emblem there. You've got everything for all your cards. There's plenty of room for your money and notes and all this kind of stuff. It's actually a pretty decent wallet. And I actually picked it up for about, I think it was about £7 or £8. It really wasn't that much. And I just thought it was quite slick and cool and geeky, but not too geeky. And I just thought it was an awesome wallet. And I thought, why not? I need to upgrade. This looked cool. So I went for it. Of course, with nerd purchase comes Funkos every time. Obviously, as I've said a million times, look at all the shit behind me. So many of it is Funko related. And I picked myself up an exclusive, which I've wanted for quite a while as well. It's the Super Saiyan Trunks, which I've wanted for quite a while, to be honest. I never saw it in regular stores like Forbidden Planet or anything like that. Finally found it here, so let's unbox it. And here we are. And it's definitely one of my favourites. I actually think I like this more than the Goku one that I got, the classic Super Saiyan Goku. And just the detail on the hair is really good, even at the back as well with the short. Yeah, if you look at the back as well, he's got his sword and everything. I think the colour is really good. You've got the Capsule Corp logo on the side and everything. He's just there with his fist down and everything. It just looks awesome. It's a cool Funko. I'm a massive Dragon Ball Z fan. I want to collect more of these. I've seen so many of them I want, but most of them are exclusives and that, and I just can't get hold of them that easily. But this is definitely one of the ones I wanted, and I'm glad that I got it, to be honest. The last thing I want to talk about is another Funko. Picked it up a couple of weeks back. I was in Coventry and Forbidden Planet, so I didn't get this at Comic-Con, but I thought I need to talk about it anyway. So, and it's Kylo Ren. I've already got a Kylo Ren, but I got the brand new Rise of Skywalker one, right there. I couldn't not pick this up. Purely just how cool it looks. If you just look at the... like, everything looks really great on the body and everything. The lightsaber, once again, is just really detailed. And I actually like the fact they've got all these grooves and everything through the cape. The detail there is good. But, come on, the best part about it is the helmet. Just look at the detail they've put in there with all the red kind of marks and everything. Because obviously in the film, he's rebuilding his helmet, so... it just looks epic. It's so cool. And one thing I've always loved about Star Wars Funkos is that they come with these little stands. Like, all the other Funkos don't do that, but Star Wars come with stands. And I love that. It kind of presents them better and makes them look more, like, worthy and worth it and everything. It just, the detail is awesome. Absolutely love this. It's probably one of my favourite Funkos out there at the minute. I'm so glad I picked it up. If any of these are interesting to you and you want to purchase them yourself, I'll put links in the description. Prices may vary depending on where I can get them from, Amazon or different websites, because some of them, obviously, I've got a couple of exclusive and whatnot. Some of them might not even be available anywhere. I generally don't know. So I will try my best to find them all and put the links in the description if you feel like picking them up yourself. So that's my nerd purchase done for November. What did you think about the products? Let me know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe and ring the bell. If you want to find me on social media, any of these, all links are in the description, and I'll see you soon.